Hello, I'm Alan and welcome to Enuts Engineering. In today's video we'll start making a prototype lever for moving the table on the cutter grinder. This is a two-part video. We'll check if milling or turning a block in the lathe is quicker, and we also have another quick tip. So let's get into the workshop.
Right, I've taken this 40mm bar, put in the four-jaw chuck. The main reason for that is that I'd have to leave it sticking out further in the three-jaw because the bore in the three-jaw is only about an inch, where in this it just goes in. I've no idea what the material is, it's easy cutting. If anybody knows, it was painted white on the end of the bar. I don't know what the white colour... I know it denotes the material, but I don't know what the material is for white. It's one of the offcuts I got from the steel stock holder. So what I've done is just faced it off, trued up the outside. I'm going to put a 5/8 bore in and then part it off. Okay, I've put the boring bar on and now I'll try and bore that out to 0.625. Just a quick tip, when you can't extract the centre, in other words you wind tailstock right back, it still doesn't extract the centre, you'll find that a Morse taper centre with the proper end on, with the tang on the end, when that goes in, it's loose when you've just wound it fully back. So you have to let the spindle go forward, then it will lock. And then when you unwind it on a Morse taper, there's enough on the length, so it's started to eject it now, that you can take it off. But with a shorter Morse taper, in other words it hasn't got the tang on the end, you've lost the half inch on the end, so that will go back, this will go back a further half inch, which brings it to the end of your travel. And it still hasn't ejected. You can mess about with grips to grip it and turn it out, but the easiest way I found is just get a small piece of wood, wind it back until it touches the wood. Now that wood has got to be just wide enough so that it will eject the centre before the centre comes to the stop. So you just wind it back onto there and it comes out. You just get used to doing it. So people who don't know may be struggling to get the centre out. So I've put the blank that I made earlier into the tool holder, clamped it down, set the tool holder square to the chuck, put it in this fly cutter. What I want to do now is put a flat face on the outside of this, maybe halfway down.
Thank you.
So basically, if you don't have a milling cutter or a fly cutter, you can still use your four-jaw chuck. What I've done is just put another one in the four-jaw chuck to face a flat. And I just wanted to see if it's any quicker in the chuck or by milling. Say it's quicker in the chuck. Okay, what I've done now is turn the block round with the flat I've just machined on this jaw, and I want to drill a hole in the centre of this and that deep. Now, because I'm coming on a curve, I can't really put a centre drill in there. All it's going to do is push it off and snap the end. So what I'm going to do is use an end mill to put a flat on there, and once I've got the flat on, I can drill the hole. In fact, I might use the end mill to go in quite a way to give me a nice surface. So the only way I could line this up is by eye, because you've got nothing you can use to set it to. And also, you use the guides on the chuck. I found it's going to be within a millimetre or two, which is okay for this. It's not critical work. All it's going to do is put a screw through here, and then when I split this ring, this screw will clamp this ring up on a bar.
I'll just drop the speed.
Because this is offsetting this chuck, there might be a bit of vibration, I don't know yet, so see how it goes. Just finished off the milling, I've centre drilled, and I've just drilled through with a 5mm hole. Now eventually this will be tapped to 6mm and it will hold this lock screw for locking. So I'll put a slot in there and it will clamp onto a bar. But for now, that's all I can do to that part. I would say it's quicker to do it on the lathe for facing off that part, and even this part's quicker than trying to use a milling cutter in the chuck. After all that, I found I've got a problem, and that this won't fit down into that hole. Probably doesn't need to do really, but for the sake of a few more thou on that, it would then fit neat. So what I've done, go back to the boring bar. Take the sharp edge off. So let's show you what we've done. faced it off. We've put a recessed hole there. We've drilled through 5mm. So we have to put a split across here so that'll clamp up. And I've just got to drill 2 5mm holes ready for tapping in the top. Just put the slot in by saw. I'm just using the lathe to true up some pieces of aluminium. And the way I do that is use a forge or chuck, put a parallel strip at the back and just tighten the two jaws. What I've done is already set the two jaws below roughly, so when this is clamped in the chuck it's roughly on centre. Just nip up the two jaws. Take the strip out. I'll stop it to check. Yep, that's all machined up. And then undo the two jaws. Basically, I've machined those two faces parallel.
Oh well, that's it for today, and we hope to see you next time for part 2 on Enots Engineering.